Oh, there's the Treasure Island. I'm sure it played a role in the Crusades. Now all the rich, they come here. And here's the entire beach here in the north of Italy, in the north of the Mediterranean. And here's the river. So this is river water. It's coming into the sea. And there's the Treasure Island. And there are the mountains with the secluded valley where the Templars Church is. There it is. So, first Treasure Island, Crusades, river, secluded valley, and then Switzerland. And here's that island, Gallinara Island. So here's a place I was at, Albenga, here it is, which is a part of the Crusades, and this is in Wikipedia. And here's their coat of arms, which they got from the Crusades, from the Templars. How many things are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Nine Sisters of Isis, probably.
Sì, Albenga è un centro, è stato un centro importante dei Templari. C'era proprio, infatti, il vescovo di Albenga pagava le decime, pagava tasse ai Templari. Però documenti si sono persi, sono spariti. Io so che c'è un libricino sui Templari d'Albenga, i Templari minori, nella libreria San Michele, San Miguel. Che è la libreria vescovile, però non so molte cose.
Molto grazie.
Prego,
molto grazie.
Prego.
So the guy, he just said that this is a very important Templars town here, Albenga.
Okay.
And this is the Red Cross in Italy here in it's a Swiss cross. Actually, it's not a Red Cross. So this is for the ambulance. Yeah. And so the man, he just told me, so this is the coat of armor of Albenga. It's a Templar's cross, eh? On his car, I suppose it's his car. So there it is, the Templar's castles in Europe, some of them. And here is Albenga, Corsica. And on the other side of the dip is, of course, here Sicily and Jerusalem. So that was quite a safe way compared to the way, like, on the other side was the Ottoman, on not yet, with the Turks. So before finally settling down in Switzerland, they passed through here. The final destination was Switzerland, where they brought the treasure of the pyramids. So this is the river, one side going to that beach there, and the other side going to the secluded valley. And here it says in Wikipedia as well, in fact, Albenga established itself as a commune in 1098, and the same year it took part to the first crusade with vessels, men and money, receiving rights of free trade by the King of Jerusalem. From that moment on, the golden Red Cross coat of arms waves on its ship and on its towers. So it played a very important role. Lion, the symbol of the royal dignity, the pharaohs and their grains are here. So they are here. And what do I find next to it? Yeah, like hidden in the mountains. The sea is just behind there. It's all hidden. These are the nice places. Huh? An octagonal church here. Yeah, with the sun hieroglyph in a form I've never seen before. Like the round thing in the middle and two things on each side. I've never seen one like this. There's the Ave Maria, but it is in the form of the square and compass. You see, and this is inside the church. I leave it open here. You can still read the date about underneath here. I can't read it. And even if it was built later, it has the octagonal form. This, the lion is here. It's all here. They're definitely here. It's nicely hidden. That's the typical thing to do. There's also these round circles. Usually they're 13, as we could have seen in many castles in France, but which the aristocracy uses. It's even down the balcony. It's all over. It all has a meaning. Yeah, probably 30. So here was the church. Octagonal. So here at the entrance of the village is a double sun hieroglyph. Quite obvious. For those who know. That's Albenga, where I filmed the beach. And the treasure angel, the treasure island, and there's the village where the Templar's church is all secluded. This is the secluded valley. Very secluded. Nice Roman church in the north of Italy, next to Lavona in Nassino. And that's the Templar's church again, hidden in the mountains, in the valley, where the pharaohs are. And these are their people. Yeah. Welcome back in the Middle Ages. So there it is, Albenga in Wikipedia. I put it all in the links for you. There was another castle, but as I was not alone, I had other things to do, so I couldn't go and look for the Templar's castle, the other one. So when the Templars came, the sea is just there, just behind. So they found themselves a nice little protected valley. Nobody getting, oh, that looks like a castle then, eh? That's probably where they had the towers to have a look around, yeah? Sure, at the sea. I think the sea is behind there as well. And here's the octagonal church. So they know it's us, and here is the Templars' treasure. You see? And they came from the Crusades. This is in the north of Italy. At the Mediterranean, the sea next to Savona, it's like Savon in French, the soap, I guess, eh? Clean place maybe. And it's an entirely abandoned village here. There's nobody living here. It says the Liberty Street, the Freedom Street. Well, it won't be free anymore. I mean, if I look at all the number plates on the cars. Switzerland, St. Gallen, Canton of Bern, they buy it all. Canton of Bern, there's Luzern, they buy it all. They just spend like a couple of days here. And here you can see the houses for sale here. Probably quite cheap. Because the young people, what can they do here? Grow olives, you know? Nothing to do. That's the rich Swiss. Vendese, it means for sale. There's even a phone number if you want to buy it. You have to do a lot of work though. So Switzerland was founded by the Templars. And now they're coming back with their cars, you just saw it. And it was founded in 1291. So why? Why are they coming back here? You know, well that's why. Probably digging there. Oh, where is it? That is, sorry. Probably digging here for years, like, get all back and then sleep at home in one of the places. Yeah. So let's get up the Freedom Street, shall we? Looks very Roman. It's very old. But this is abandoned. It's middle age. Nobody here. Hardly. I heard this. Only one person living here permanently. The rest is, some of them are just like rich Swiss. And they just come and after they made a lot of bucks in Switzerland, some with the criminal banks. I spent Christmas here or something. It's very nice. It's beautiful. It's a nice atmosphere. It is called Massino. Nobody there. The Freedom Street in Massino. Apparently it means the little nose. Nassino. Well, they say the Jews have big noses. I never really noticed that. Some of them maybe. But I do know that the aristocrats, they have long noses with a high ridge. The typical Jews, they have like a round part of at the tip of their noses. But the aristocrats, they have these long noses. So here are the small noses, and the people probably knew that they were not part of them. Or maybe they already mixed that much. You couldn't recognize them anymore, so they call them Nassino, the small noses, yeah? Interesting. Well, here the small noses used to live. I also saw the Sun Euroclip. I'm going just down the village. Let's see if we can find some more small noses. Hey, it's all abandoned. The small nose. No more small noses. They went to Switzerland. First they hid the treasure here, and then they went terrorizing the Europeans, and all, and now they're terrorizing the third world, the Muslims, the Africans. But the same thing has already happened with the Europeans. I mean, the genocide on the Celtic people, that was the biggest genocide in the whole world. When Caesar, he murdered them all, like this guy Vercingetorix, the Gaul. The Gallic leader. There's a more Swiss living there. So more on top of the small nose village. Did they resist? I don't think they did. Well, otherwise there wouldn't be so many Swiss here. They are the ones who mix that much, that you can't see the big noses anymore. And again, that's not Jewish. That's aristocratic, pharaonic. The Pyramid Mountain. And that was the church down there. This too is in Wikipedia. And in fact, this is interesting. The Temple Mount, Dome of the Rock, and the Al-Aqsa mosque in Jerusalem must have been constructed by the Templars, because it's octagonal, and here it says, in fact, that it was made by the Templars. And so like three sort of obelisks, it's always three. So this is the place, the same place where the beach was, Al Benga. It's always on the roundabouts. So this is Isis, Horus and Seth, the Horus matrix. So Isis, that's the one who's ruling. And here in Italy, they always worship Maria, which is the same thing. Very same thing. Oh, here's another roundabout in Al Benga. It's a very Masonic place. See, forming the oval, like all these rings, Gucci, MasterCard, the Olympic Games and everything, you know. And they even put it here. I mean, they're perfectionists. Look at that. Three. That's Isis, Horus and Seth. Yeah, they're perfectionists. It's all over. Well, of course, after the Crusades, I mean, this is where they landed, amongst others. These are the places. And the other one, the other roundabout is just the next roundabout. So very Masonic. I don't know what kind of a lizard that is, but it's again the three on a roundabout, you know, the three obelisks here. Sort of a lizard without a head, I don't know. Yeah, the bridge here over the river, going to the, so this is in the middle of Al Benga. As the old man said, it's a, well, I already felt it, you know. It's important for the Templars. I mean, it's all here. There's a river going inland, the secluded valley, the treasure island. It's all here, you know. Let's see if they stop for me. Here too, the Vesica Paiche. All over. Hey, that's them. The grain, our blood is here. We're all pharaonic. Well, there they are, all Templars. Yeah, it's a very important place for the Templars. Oh yes. Yeah. Before they went to Switzerland. Which is even safer for them. That's Isis. Hello, Isis. Old church. Yeah, it's about the Templars' houses in northwest Italy, which Al Benga is in fact. There's about Al Benga. The Templar House of Al Benga, 1143. When the Templars arrived in Al Benga, and well, I put in the links. The logo of the SS symbol with the pyramid and the sun. You know, they have it all in there. The Enterprise is there. Yeah, the Templar's cross and the symbol of Al Benga. That must be all. Interesting coat of arms. A lion, the symbol of the aristocracy, the black horse, or unicorn even. Nazis. Oh, now, oh man, this is heavy here. Another black horse. Nice church. The basic apertures, the rings. That means we keep together. Alone, one ring. We're not that strong. The checkers board of Masons, but together we are very strong in an organization. Yeah. But there must be some sort of a story with this here, with the slingshot. I don't know. And there's the other Mason. It's still the same, the three obelisks as we saw before. On another place. Lizards. Fleur de lis. The joining of the Freemasons, that means we keep together. Together we're strong. Looks like a synagogue here. Probably a Templar's church. This looks like a synagogue. I don't know. Oh, there's the octagon. Fleur de lis, the aristocracy of the pharaohs. So there's the coat of arms again, Albenga, the world domination, we rule the whole world. And here is the marketplace. There's the sun hieroglyph a couple of times. There. Something on it. Typical sun hieroglyph of the pharaohs. Quite occult here. Ah, we're even being filmed. Look at it. Two. There's one. There's one. Probably with a microphone as well. They probably hear everything, you know, he's saying. Ah, there's some more there. Oh, look at that. There. Whoa. So it's not only the all-seeing eye, it's the real all-seeing eye. Octagonal. Templars. Lots of lions here, symbol of the pharaonic domination. There never were any lions here. Yeah. And it's the logo of the aristocracy, who are pharaohs. Their paws on the world, so that's the world domination. That one too. It's so typical. These are the same things those pharaohs in the Arab Emirates in Qatar, where the soccer championship will be, you know, like in the sea. It must have a reason. It's older. It must be some pharaonic papyrus or something. The world domination. Right, it's all there.
The cow of the pharaohs. It's also the symbol of their, you know, the defense system. That's why the Yanks, they have one out here. Really, the Americans, they have the APIS, which is the Advanced Passenger Information System after the Patriot Act. That's one of the most important things of the Patriot Act, actually. I made a film about it, so I'll just go and have a look.
It's quite hard to film in here, there's a lot of sun hieroglyphs, old ones, so there's a very ancient thing. So still in Albanga. Well, the good thing here about Italy is, compared to the land of calculations, you can park anywhere, you know, it doesn't cost anything. In the land Switzerland, the land of calculations, everywhere you have to pay. Nothing is free. Only their terror on others, that's for free, you know? So, good. Quite in the center. There's a very interesting cyclist here. There, where the sea is, the humidity of the sea, because of the heat, it goes up, and it can only go up because it's all mountains here, as you can see. And it even goes higher and higher. Afterwards are the Alps, I suppose. So then, it all, there's so much humidity at a certain moment, and it gets heavier and heavier. And finally it condensates, and if it's so heavy, full of water, then it's clouds come back and it starts raining, and that's why it's so green here, even in the south of Europe, in Italy, which usually is not that green. So this is because of this peculiar cyclus, where the mountains are directly starts from the beach on. Very beautiful. I have some very nice products here in Italy, biological wine, this one here, and a beer that tastes like beer, not like mass production. That tastes like water. So this is the place we were staying at. Today's a rainy day. An Italian castle. Well, someone living here at number 81 in the castle. To ring the bell here. Probably Freemason stuff. Nice, inviting for a nice Freemason party, whatever they do. And the Freemasons, they are the aristocracy, the old world order, and the Freemasons the new world order. That's why they always are in castles, and they were before the pharaohs, no doubt about that. So there's an interesting road going up here. An interesting path. Let's have a look. What does it say here? So the church is there next to the castle. They always went hand in hand, the Pope and the King, terrorizing the people. And there's the castle. So today is still the same thing, the aristocracy, the King there, and the Pope here. As we can see, the New World Order, the Freemasons, well, they're still the same as the Old World Order, the aristocracy. Like you see Obama visiting the Pope and Tony Blair visiting the Pope. It's still the very same thing. This looks like a stupa, like the Tibetan sort of a Buddhist thing on top here. And there's another one. That's sort of weird. Another stupa. World domination. Nothing has changed, they're always next to each other. There are little scorpions here. In Italy. Whoa. Bloody scorpion, eh? Now, apparently all castles are private property in Italy. And we can see the same round things here, which we have already seen at many castles in France. So this belongs to a count, Conti, a count, Le Comte, from the 14th century. So the only interesting thing I can get here is this symbol here. What does it say? Interesting. Sort of a world. Sort of a light coming out. This looks like one of those, the bell. One of those Nazi UFOs. Weird. Wow. What are they all hiding from us, eh? So that's the church next to it. We are at 600 meters. It's very, very clean here. You would hardly say this is Italy. It's, very clean and tidy. Almost like Switzerland in a way. So the castle is there and the church is here. It's always the same, church and castle. Just as today when the presidents were all aristocrats. All those politicians of the New World Order, who were originally from the Old World Order, they come and shake hands with the Pope. Yeah, it's all next to each other. Church, they always went hand in hand. Church and... So here's some story about the castle. For whom? Those who understand Italian. Well, let's have a look into the church here. So this is a very Catholic place here, Italy. I didn't bring my torch with me, unfortunately. So there's a lot of... and I only got a 30 megabyte per second card if I had my 80.
then it would be easier. But there's a lot of sun hieroglyphs here, pharaonic here, as we find on a lot of houses, and as a secret symbol. So here they are in the country where they came from and apparently killed the man. There he is, that's the man. And they celebrate it, as this religion is nothing else. It symbolizes domination over man. I mean, you got your hand, he's got his hands tied on the cross. Where is he? There he is. There's the man. That symbolizes man. You got your hands nailed to the cross, so you can't defend yourself. It's forbidden. You got your feet nailed, so you can't run away. It's a total control. You can just nod your head and say, yes, darling, no, darling, yes, Isis, no, Isis, yes, Mr. Judge, no, Mr. Judge, yes, General, yes, sir, you know. Well, the Freemasons. So the bloke here just turned the light on. This is another sun hieroglyph with a king in it. The pharaohsocracy, it's the pharaohs and the sun hieroglyph, you see. And there's another one, another king. Kings and religion, it's all pharaonic. It all fits together. It's a pity I can't visit the castle then, eh? So these are, this is the a monument for Italian fascists who died on the Eastern Front. It's a Fronte Russo. They fought for the Nazis. What a waste, you know. So he has the flag and everything. So all this financed by Switzerland, who financed Hitler and the Nazis. It was a Swiss idea of the Swiss Nazi Templars. What are the Italians doing on the Eastern Front fighting the Russians? Why? You know, so stupid. All these people who ended in the concentration camp. And there's the Templars. The ones who did it. And their victims, all together in one image. Nice. They're the Nazi Templars, the aristocracy who did it, the pharaohs, and their victims. Well, isn't that nice? They're all together. Wow, man. Chemtrails.